Good morning and welcome to this week's Junior Church Sunday Special. Today we are continuing with the story that Philip started last week in the family service. Do you remember how we heard how the disciples went fishing? And then afterwards they came in and they had breakfast with Jesus on the beach. So we are going to continue with the theme of fishing and we're going to play a game. So if you'd like to play the game at home later, what you need is a fish, preferably made out of tissue paper, but newspaper would probably work, and a magazine. And I'm going to ask Harrison and Charlie to play the game and show us how that works. Thank you, Harrison and Charlie.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone. This is Harrison and Charlie, and they're going to show you how to play the game Kippers, where you have to fan your fish, as you can see here, over the floor, which is the ocean, to a fishy finishing line down here, as you can see. So, boys, are you ready?
Yeah.
On the count of three. One, two, three. Well done, guys.
Suppose you wanted to start a new organisation. Maybe you wanted to start a sports club that met in your village and then in the next town. And then you had big plans and ambitions. You wanted this sports club to spread over the whole world. I wonder who you'll choose to run it. I'm guessing someone who was honest, trustworthy, reliable, and never let you down. Well, Jesus is going to start an organisation that will start small, but spread all over the world. And it's going to be called the Church. Now, I wonder who he will choose to head it up. Let's see. Last week, we learnt how Jesus and his friends went fishing, and then they had breakfast with Jesus on the beach. Now, when they'd finished eating, Jesus turned to Peter and he said, "Peter, son of John, do you love me?" And Peter said, "Yes, Jesus, you know that I love you." If Peter is going to be useful to Jesus, then he has to love Jesus. He has to love him. Do we love Jesus? Do you love Jesus? Do I love Jesus? If Peter was going to be useful to Jesus, it was the most important question. But do we love Jesus? How do we know if we love Jesus? Jesus said to Peter, "Feed my lambs." And then Jesus asked the question again. He said, "Peter, son of John, do you love me?" And again Peter replied, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." Jesus replied, "Look after my sheep." And then Jesus asked Peter for the third time. He said, "Peter, do you love me?" Now, Peter was upset. He said to Jesus, "Why are you asking me that question again? You know everything, Jesus. You know that I love you." And Jesus replied, "Feed my sheep." So, why did Jesus ask that question three times? Well, if you were listening to Sam's brilliant talk in the main service, the 10:30 service, you probably will have spotted the link and why Jesus asked the question three times. Let's think back to when Jesus was being tried. Do you remember that Peter was outside in the courtyard and someone asked him, they said to him, "Aren't you one of his disciples?" And Peter said, "I am not." And then someone else asked him, "Aren't you one of his disciples?" And Peter said, "No, I'm not." And then for the third time, someone else said, Didn't I see you in the garden with Jesus when he was arrested? And Peter said, no, no, you've got the wrong person. And just then, the cock crowed. Did you see that cock that Sam made? Wasn't that clever? They're making that cock out of those hearts. Brilliant. Okay, so three times Peter had denied Jesus. And Jesus was, by asking the question three times, he was showing that he had forgiven Peter three times. And it's only when Peter's forgiven that he can be restored and recommissioned and carry on with the work that Jesus gives him. And this question, let's ask ourselves this question, have we been forgiven by Jesus? Have you been forgiven by Jesus? This question helps us answer the first question, do we love Jesus? Because it's only when we've been forgiven by Jesus that we can truly love Jesus. So Peter was restored and forgiven by Jesus, and Peter said, I'm giving you a very special job to do. You are going to look after my sheep and feed my lambs. Remember that Jesus said that he was the good shepherd. So Jesus was asking Peter, even though Peter had denied him three times, he was asking him to look after his people, his sheep, to feed them, to teach them God's word, and to care for them. And he wanted Peter, even though Peter had denied him three times, to build his new church, to lead his new church. Peter was to feed the people with God's word and to look after them. He was going to teach them how to love Jesus and how to grow as his disciples. One more thing. Later on, Jesus said to Peter, follow me. Now, do you remember that's what Jesus said to Peter and his friends when he first met him? He said, follow me. I'm going to make you fishers of men. Follow me. So, will Peter follow Jesus? Well, he had been for 3 years. Will we follow Jesus? Will we follow Jesus? Peter was recommissioned and restored. He loved Jesus, had been forgiven by Jesus, and followed Jesus. And Jesus used him to teach and grow the church. What about us? Have we been forgiven by Jesus so that we can love him and therefore follow him? Jesus longs for us to turn to him to be forgiven so we can love him and follow him and serve him and tell others about Jesus and help to teach people to become his disciples and help to grow the church. So our memory verse today is, Peter, son of John, do you love me? It's quite an easy one, isn't it? Peter, son of John, do you love me? And that's from John chapter 21, verse 17. Peter, son of John, do you love me? John chapter 21, verse 17. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you that you forgave Peter and restored him so that he could love you and follow you. And Father, please would you forgive us our sins so that we can love you with our whole hearts and follow you and be used by you to help feed other people and tell them about Jesus and help to build your church. Father, please help us in Jesus' precious name. Amen. And now we have some craft to do. So we'll just go inside and we're going to make a fish today. Well, welcome to the craft session. Today we're going to make a fish like this, which is rather easy, and I hope you'll have most of the things at home. We need a plastic bag in this sort of shape, cone shape like that. Now to do this, just take an ordinary bag that you might use for your lunch and hold one corner and then pull it like that and then cut it off there to make this shape like that. And then you can fill it with all sorts of different coloured bits and pieces. I've got these nets here, and this is rather good. This came off some meat, so I just put that in first, and that sort of gives the impression of the scales. And look, these are just bags you'll recognise from Satsumas. Stuff them in here. You could use tissue paper or coloured paper from magazines. Just fill up the bag like this. Keep on stuffing with different coloured. There we are. That's probably about right. Maybe a little bit of tissue paper. Here we are. A bit of tissue paper to go in as well. There we are. Now, do you see I've made these streamers to be the tail? And for that, I've got a piece of tissue paper and just tore it. I think it looks neat. Nice if you tear it. So one, just two. And then on the right-hand edge, end, write your questions. So do you love Jesus? There we are. There's a question mark. So now we can, put it this way around. Put it there and then put three in the bag. That's right. You'll put your third one in. And then you need a loom band. Here we are. Or if you haven't got a loom band, just use a plastic. Just use a rubber band. Just use a larger one. Now I can do it that way. And we need an eye. If you've got a goggle eye, use one like that, put on the eye. And if not, you can just cut a piece of round card, do the pupil. There we are, I'll stick that, put that on the other side. So there's our fish. And with our three questions, do you love Jesus? Have you been forgiven by Jesus? Will you follow Jesus? So that's our lesson today. Thank you for joining us. It's been lovely to have you. And hopefully we'll see you again next week. Goodbye.
Very clever. Thank you, Caroline.